us, Dr. Buford, is getting started on the left shoulder. We're looking at from the back to the front. Everything that you see is magnified 30 or 40 times on the screen. Right now we've got an instrument called the shaver coming in. This just helps us because you can use it as a probe. We can also use it to debride any inflammatory tissue or any scar tissue that we see. So first thing we usually look for is the biceps tendon, which is a strong rope-like structure running up towards the top of the screen. And it actually looks very good. We'll look down at the biceps anchor, and that looks great. Okay. Hold the shaver, please. We're going to rotate and look towards the back of the shoulder here. As we push down and look back here, the posterior glenoid, there's a little bit of soft tissue on our face. Don't mind that. Posterior glenoid and labrum look fine. Posterior capsule looks good. We're going to come back up and look at the rotator cuff, and I think we may have good news for you, at least on this side of the tendon. Things actually look pretty good. That really doesn't look like a tendon that's ever had any surgery. So, I'm happy with the way that looks for now. We're going to look on the other side. Sometimes these tears start on the bursal side. Got a little bit of a... That looks pretty good. Okay, that looks pretty good. So we'll look down the front of the shoulder. Here's the subscap tendon. A little bit of fraying at the superior border, but that's normal. And the rest of this tendon is very solid, and we were very strong in the office. And then as we look down the front of the shoulder, this looks good. So we're going to look around inside the joints a little bit longer. If there's anything else significant, we'll come back up on the video. But otherwise, the next thing we look at will be in the subacromial space. Okay, so now we're looking in the subacromial space. This is a burr coming in from the back of your shoulder to the right, front of your shoulders to the left. A little bit of bone hanging down here, so we're just going to start the burr. Pick up a little bit of this anterior lift just to level out the acromion. This is the bone that makes up the roof of the shoulder. Just put 10 pounds on the white, please. Shaver and have a good look at the rotator cuff on this side. This is why we look on the bursal side, even though things look... Push in on that camera. Okay. Even though it looks good on the articular side, when we get to the bursal side, look what we see here. This is where we've lost some integrity in the cuff, and this is what's hiding that tear that we saw on the ultrasound. So if I undo that little part, you'll see how big this tear really is. I'll keep working and I'll show you some more in a minute. Pause, please. Okay, so here's the hole in the tendon. We're going to fix this right here. First, we're going to put in a slightly bigger cannula in the back of the shoulder. We'll do that and show you some more in a minute. But there's the hole. I pulled up too far. There's the hole right there. Just exploring this tear, you can see how the inner part of the central part of the tendon is pretty beat up in there. But it does look like the tear stops right there. Let me show you some more in just a minute. I was just planning our suture anchor placement. We're going to place our first anchor. You can get it down. I don't want to be too far lateral, but I want to be right up in here somewhere. I think it's right there. I may be able to do this with one anchor. Okay. Okay, so here's our guide for the anchor. We're going to place this kind of centrally located. Here. capacitor here, and we've got our suture hook. It's loaded with a black wire called the super shuttle that you see there. We're going to reduce this, and actually I'd like to reach underneath if I can.